హాయ్ హలో, అందరికి నమస్కారం. ఐ వెల్కమ్ యూ ఆల్ టు మై షో. మీరు వింటున్నారు తెలుగు ఎన్ఆర్ఐ రేడియో. ఇది ప్రవాసాంధ్రుల గుండె చప్పుడు విత్ మీ యువర్ ఆర్జే వినయ. ఎస్, ఈరోజు ఒక స్పెషల్ లైవ్ షో జరగబోతోంది. దేని గురించి అంటే, ద బగ్గింగ్ ఇష్యూ. మెనీ ఆఫ్ మై ఫ్రెండ్స్ ఆర్ వర్కింగ్ ఆన్ H4ED అండ్ ఆర్ వరిడ్ సిక్ అండి. ఐ సిన్సియర్లీ హోప్ దెర్ ఇస్ అ సొల్యూషన్ టు దిస్. సో దాని గురించి మాట్లాడడానికి గెస్ట్లు ఉన్నారు ఇవాళ మన షోలో. మీకు ఎటువంటి డౌట్స్ ఉన్నా, ఎటువంటి క్వశ్చన్స్ ఉన్నా వాళ్ళతో మాట్లాడొచ్చు. అండ్ టుడే వీఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ ద కాన్వర్సేషన్ విత్ మిస్టర్ డాన్, హూ ఇస్ ద ఫౌండర్ ఆఫ్ నాన్ ప్రాఫిట్ ట్రేడ్ గ్రూప్ కాల్డ్ ఐటీ ప్రో అలయన్స్. డాన్ నందన్ ఈజ్ అన్ ఐటీ కన్సల్టింగ్ సబ్జెక్ట్ మ్యాటర్ ఎక్స్పర్ట్ an immigration blogger with over 20 years of experience in the IT industry. He was featured in computerworld.com, the Silicon Review, Times of India, and many career and immigration TV shows. And also we have Netra Chavan with us today. Netra has formed the Facebook group for H4 and H1B visa holders in 2009, which today has more than 53,000 growing members. She is a very vocal H1B and H4 visa supporter who has taken part in numerous events and rallies and met several members of congressmen, sharing with them the plights of H1B, especially H4 visa holders. Hello, Dan and Netra. Welcome to my show. How are you both doing today?
Yeah, hello.
Hello, Vinaya. How you doing? Thanks for bringing us on this very powerful your radio show and the radio itself. I'm doing pretty good. How you doing?
I'm doing good, Dan. Hello, Netra.
Hello, Vinaya. How are you? Thank you for having me here.
Thanks. Yes. Already we have callers. Can we take the calls?
Sure.
Hello, hi, who is this? Hello? Hello, hi Andy, we call on her. Hello, hi Andy, ever mad let her?
Yeah, hi. This is Satish. This call is regarding this H4ED itself, right?
Okay. We have Dan and Netra with us today. Please go ahead and ask your questions.
Yeah, so we just wanted to know what is the current status of that H4EAD, how soon, what is the speculation of it? My wife is working on that H4EAD, and there are a couple of more of my friends who are also working on H4EAD who are completely dependent on this. So we just wanted to know how is the situation and how soon we can expect some response. Do we have some time on that?
Okay, I can take that. The DHS has submitted a proposal to revoke the H4 EAD on the 28th of February. That's last year, last month. It's been a month. DHS has sent the revocation policy to the Office of Management and Budget to review and approve. And from the 28th of last month, we are talking about roughly 90 days before they review and put it for public comments. So it is unknown, but it's usually within 90 days when something comes into the Office of Management and Budget for a review, they usually take up to 90 days to put a policy on their website for public comments. So the public comments period is about 30 days, and then they make a decision on either to keep the H4 EAD or rescind the H4 EAD program in its entirety. And if somebody is already working, it is most unlikely that if they have a valid EAD card, that they're going to take away the valid existing EAD card. But unfortunately, at this moment, it's unknown.
Okay, so hardly we have from February 28th onwards, we have just 4 months of time to get some updates. Yes, sir, no?
Exactly. We have 4 months to get an update, so that's why we are working hard to let the administration know that there are a lot of people who would suffer if there is a revocation on the H4 EAD. So we opened a petition online. Please share with your friends as well. We have about 61,000 signatures so far. If you just Google H4 EAD petition or go to saveh4ead.com, that's where you can find the link. So we need support from everyone to let the government know that a lot of people will suffer.
Yeah, Yeah, I already did that. I also shared with that a couple of my friends, and I continue to doing that as well. And when you told me that whoever here having a valid, so do the government allow, I mean, in the worst case, if they have revoke also, do the government allow to whatever the people who are having, they'll be able to work until their validity, but renewals will not be there. Will that be case or straight away?
Yes,
from
most likely. Most likely, because, you know, I'm positive that they will not say, people with existing EAD work permits, they should, you know, shut off same day. So it's most likely that's going to happen. At this point, it's unknown.
Okay. Yeah, but again, a very big problem to all the people. And yeah, thank you. Thanks for taking my call.
Thank you.
Yeah. Bye-bye. And we have two more callers. Hello. Hi, who's this? Hello. I see two more callers here. Hello. Hello, can you hear me? Hello? Hello? I don't know. Yeah. So our discussion topic today is the most obvious one, the H4AD revocation, which is a hot topic right now. So listeners, to discuss more about this in detail, we have Dan and Netra with us today. And in Kokasar numbers announced chestestanu US nunchi call chestunnataithe 9197012005, India listeners 9705222005, UK listeners 11588200005. Skype nunchi connect avali anukunte Telugu NRI Radio ane user tho connect ayipochu. You can also mail us to telugunriradio@gmail.com. Okay, Dan, it looks like you have opened a petition on the White House website, right, to save the H4EAD. Can you please provide more details? And also, I heard that these petitions don't work at all and it's a waste of time. Then why should people sign it?
That's a good question. A lot of people asked me, why should one open a petition now? There are several methods we can connect with the government. Just to give you a little background on the petition, we opened this on the 22nd of Feb, right after the Department of Homeland Security submitted the proposal into Office of Management and Budget, and there were about 10 to 20,000 signatures same day. And right now we're about 61,000. To answer the question if the petitions do their work, honestly, maybe they should, because this is on the White House website, and the information that the White House website clearly states that if 100,000 signatures are gathered, now they will definitely review the petition and provide a response, you know. And I do not know, these are kind of, messages that go on social media stating these petitions don't work. And many of them who've been talking about stating these petitions don't work, these are typically people who are in the same boat and, you know, who have never opened a petition. Right. So there are, if you go to the White House website yourself, there have been responses to a lot of petitions given by the government. But hey, at least we have to try, right?
Right. Exactly. Yes. And Netra,
yes.
You have created a Facebook group on H4 and H1B visa holders in 2009, right? And which today has like 53,000 members, and you have even met with senators and congressmen. What was the motive and what was the result?
So I have opened this group especially for the H4 visa holders in 2009 because I was on the similar boat, and I was also getting we were also facing a lot of challenges family-wise, husband being on H1B. So during those days, like sitting at home, getting bored, I used the power of internet and started this group. Later on, it really helped to clear many doubts related to H4 and H1B visa holders. But the main when I really become vocal was the H4EAD when it was approved. So once it was approved, there was this, it got into the federal registry. And so there were like a lot of comments and everything was there in place. And H4EAD rule became, employment authorization were issued to H4 H-4 visa holders. But the time came when the lawsuit was filed against it, and H-4 EAD rule was about to be removed, or it was going to get revoked. In this situation, I reached out to Senator Ro Khanna in California here, and I requested him to get me onto a special meeting with them, with along with the Save H-4 EAD team, of course. And we really tried our level best to help him understand through the town hall meeting that this is like very important and sensible decision made by the government, and this has to this is not to be taken away. So in that situation, I met with Senator Ro Khanna. I did meet with many other senators as well regarding the green card backlog issues. So I met with Senator Rand Paul, Senator Mike Kaufman, Senator Roger Marshall, as well as Pete Session during the rally for green card backlog in DC.
Very nice. Awesome, Netra. And we have callers with us today. Hello. Hi.
Sure.
Hello.
Hello. Hi. Hi, I'm Vanaja here.
Hi, Vanaja. Where are you calling from?
I'm calling from New Jersey.
Yes, please ask your questions.
Yeah. Hi, Dan and Netra. So the question I have is about the awareness of H4 EAD. I've been reading a lot of articles. My question is, like, there is no the anti, what do you call, Save Jobs USA motive group also. I didn't see that nobody has mentioned how H4 EAD's spouses are taking up the roles of Americans over here, because I myself have 10 plus years experienced in IT industry, and I have a master's degree from a accredited institution. So when I compare myself to an OPT or someone who was born in America and who is just on a master's degree, just a fresher. So when I'm opting out for a job, I'm opting for a manager level job. Certainly, I think OPT people are the freshest, can't get hired for that job. So why is the criteria not mentioned in H4E? Very
Hello? Hello?
Hello? Hello? I think the call dropped. Dan? Yeah, do you want to answer about
that? Yeah, I will. Netra, you want to take this or should I do an explanation? It's a good point. Now, Vanaja, it looks like your call dropped, but then the one thing we need to understand here. If you're looking at the IT sector with the 80,000 to 100,000 H4 EAD cards,
I think Vanaja has joined again now. Hello, Vanaja. Hello. Hello. Go ahead, Dan. I think.
Okay. Now, with the 80,000 to 100,000 EADs that were granted since the 2015, during the Obama administration, May 26, 2015, when the rule was enacted, these jobs, if you're looking at the skilled experience jobs, as in the information technology jobs, these EAD card holders are probably taking jobs which are not filled by the U.S. workers. Number one, every person, everyone listening to the radio today, should understand that these H-4 EADs are not taking away any U.S. citizen or U.S. worker, like a green card holder or a U.S. citizen's jobs. And this looks like as an extension into the H-1B visa, where you have additional workforce which can otherwise fill jobs which are kept open forever, and the H-4 EADs have taken those jobs, number one. And I've heard yesterday someone said, hey, they are coming to Walmart, they're coming to other stores and taking away these jobs. Walmart is a large corporation. I'm just giving you an example of Walmart. They're not going to lay off U.S. workers and then, you know, start hiring H-480s. They have, when they get an application, they only look for if somebody had a valid work authorization. Maybe there are no people available in that area where the store is located. And Macy's, Walmart's are, you know, due to, based on the geographic population, they're probably picking, you know, hiring people who are local. And I'm 100% sure the human resources at these large corporations don't even know what we're talking about. They just, you know, somebody applies for an opportunity. They look if they have a valid work permit. It's an equal opportunity. You know, we have to understand Walmart or any other employer cannot discriminate stating you have an EAD card. We only want to hire U.S. citizens. That's the problem. So if you look at the Buy American, Hire American, Hire American, Buy American program is not in line with the equal opportunity employment regulations.
Right.
There's a lot of, you know, it's kind of, you know, under the Hire American, Buy American, your first shot should be to hire U.S. Workers. But then on the other side, the equal employment opportunity regulations have not been revised based on the Hire American, Buy American.
Right. Great. Thanks, Dan.
And secondly, whatever is happening with H-4 EAD today, it's, as she said, the awareness is not there in the market, because we H-4 EAD need to bring this awareness as well. So government has already issued a work permit to these H-4 spouses, but at the market level, or considering the openings or hirings taking place at the local areas, the awareness is still not there. So they will only consider the work permit that is given to the H-4s.
Yes, yes. Hello, hi, who is this?
Sorry, Vanija, I've just connected back.
Yes, hi, Vanija. Please go ahead.
Yeah, I heard what Dan said, and it sounds, I mean, like there's information in it, but what I see from past 1 month after OMB's proposed rule has been submitted, that all the articles, whether Americans are writing about it on Facebook or Twitter or Instagram, all I find is there is lack of information about real skill set employees also exist in this quota of 1 lakh applications, whether they are from China or from India. So the spouses, how are they differing, L2 spouses from H4 EAD spouses? Like, both of them are skill set people. They come for the company's internal tool, and H1 comes for the highly skilled set, but the spouses remain the same. Like, it's not like L2 spouses are all master's degree holders, or they have highly experienced people, and H4 EAD spouses are not. So how are they differentiating it, and why are they not getting targeted, or why is someone not appealing on this point of view, that when you are giving authorization for L2 spouses, how are H4 EAD spouses different from them? So
I will take this
right.
Okay, so for as you are comparing with H4 versus L2, so L2 EAD is itself a law, okay, whereas H4 EAD is a rule, and anyone can, every admin has a right either to revoke this particular rule. So when it comes to H4 EAD revoke rule, when I discussed this with Senator Ro Khanna, that why this is happening, what you are saying it on the similar terms, he just mentioned that every admin will have this right either to approve it or to revoke it. Maybe this admin is revoking it. Maybe if other admin comes in, they might again approve it. So this happiness and sadness cycle will keep coming and going for the H4 spouses. So we all have to come together and try to make this H4 EAD as law. Unless and until this becomes law, it is very difficult for us at minority level, for all the H4 spouses, to face this challenge. Now, when you are comparing H4 EAD to L2 EAD, I would like to just say that it is the quantity and not the quality. The quantity, the number of L2 EADs that are coming in every year in US is very low as compared to H4 EADs who are coming in. I hope this answers your question.
Yeah, it really answered my question and most of the other H4 spouses, I guess. So one last question on this law is, what can we do as H4 EAD holders to, I mean, is there anything in our hands which we can do to ask them or request them to do, to take it as a law other than signing up the petition?
Correct. So as of now, we have
I can take that. Yeah,
yes,
sorry,
please
go ahead
then.
no, go ahead.
Dan,
please.
You want to take? Okay. Okay, so...
You know, I just wanted to add something here. What is that, you know, unfortunately, as Netra was mentioning, this is a rule. And people have asked me, hey, can we file a lawsuit? Maybe no, because it's, you know, it's not completely a law. The administration has the authority to revoke the program. Now, the first step is to, you know, we have taken the first step, and depending on what happens with the first step with the petition, we will definitely look into, we are talking to, on behalf of IT Pro Alliance, I'm talking to other advocacy groups. We're not an immigration advocacy group, but then I'm in touch with a couple of them and see what we can do on this side. Tomorrow we have 100,000 people sign this and say, hey, you know, look at this. 100,000 people have signed this petition. Now we need to do something different to request the government from maybe bringing the law back. So it's just because, you know, today they have revoked the program, it does not mean that they won't bring it back. So we have to continue to fight, especially for the Indian nationals, looking at the way the green cards to get a benefit of the EAD card if you are 140 or you are your principal applicant. If you have a 140 after 2009, it might take forever, I don't know how many years, to get into the final stage to get the benefit of an EAD card. So, Netra, please, over to you.
Yeah, sure. So,
Netra, before you talk, we have one more caller. Let me quickly say hi to him. Hello?
Oh, sure.
Hello? Hello, hi, who is this? Hello? Yeah, Netra, please go ahead.
Yeah, so Vanaja was asking for the steps we can take towards saving this H4 EAD rule, so or to make it as a law. So to make it as a law, it's a big step which all the immigration organizations will have to come together and focus on H4 EAD and focus on the root cause, that is the green card backlog, which they are already doing it. So for to save this, since H4 EAD being the priority right now, I would request, I mean, every time my members keep saying that we are the foreigners on this land, we are not supposed to take any actions, our ask will not be answered properly, or we will have to anyway suffer and surrender the way it's everything is going. So to my all the public listeners right now, I really request you that every comment that will you will put forth towards this saving this H4 EAD once the comment period opens up, your every comment should, if it falls into 85% to 90% positive, then this law, this rule, which is revocation of H4 EAD rule, can we all can together bring it on hold. The second thing is you can, at this level, you can reach your local senators and explain your stories, like explain your real-time scenarios, what will happen if this H4 EAD rules is set back. You can also attend the local town hall meetings and request and bring awareness and say it loud in front of the hall and ask, like, why is this happening with only H4 spouses, and this will actually bring awareness to the citizens who are present in the town hall. And later on, you can always talk one-on-one to the senator who is there, who is present there, to take your special meeting for yourself. Plus, the town hall meetings will also give an opportunity to connect with the local media, because most of the time, every town hall meeting has at least 2 to 3 medias present, and they are always looking for the news in immigration. So you will be like a storyline for them to explain like why this situation is so critical for you and how the government needs to help you to come out of this. Yes, Vinaya. Hello.
Hello.
Dan.
I'm here. Vinaya, you're still there? Did we lose you?
So Dan, this is like H4EAD is not issued to everyone. I feel it is just issued to
you,
the.
Netra, can you pause for a second? We don't know if we are still on the air.
Oh, okay.
I'm not sure. So.
Hello, Dan. Sorry, I think some technical issues. Hello.
Oh. Vinaya,
I think we have a caller with us today. Yeah. Hello. Hi. Who is this? Hello? I don't know, they're not talking. Okay, Netra, can you please provide us more information about your background and your H4 journey?
Actually, it's there. My article is there on the American Bazaar online.com, so you can go through it. But other than that, like, I landed in this country after marriage in 2006, and I mean, being on H4 visa, I just thought I was well aware that I'm not supposed to work here, but I never thought it will take such a long journey just to get a work permit in US. So for me, it was like 11 years long wait. And so this really is very frustrating, sitting at home idle and doing nothing, frankly. And frankly speaking, I mean, most of them just tell me, why don't you just leave and go back? See, excuse me, we are here because we also care for our husbands. We know that being on H1B is like a dream for them as well, to be here, to work here. And if they are really doing good, why we being selfish and take them away from their dream to just fulfill our dreams? So that's why we just continue and adjust and compromise with so many things going on with our spouses. So it's not just for my spouses, but in general, this is the situation for all the H4 ladies right now.
Right. And to add up this, Netra, women with H4 EADs who doesn't want to work is their personal choice, right? But many will be like, you know, very much career aspirants and they want to work. Especially who comes from India will be like missing their family, and coming here, they feel like as if they're in jail or something. And that will seriously get into some depression, you know. Unlike something is keeping you occupied, then it's okay. And one more thing, states like California is one nice place. If you don't work also, you still get to see sunlight outside and bright weather. It's like very lively. And also about CAs, it's very, very expensive compared to other states. So both have to work. So most of the families, you know, they try to pedal up and they want to support their husband, the family. If both are working, it might help them, right? And at this position, if EAD is stuck at home, this is so sad. I don't know how to take this. Yeah, do you want to say something about that?
Right. So regarding, I would like to say something regarding the green card backlog, or what we just said about we taking away the jobs of Americans. So usually what is happening right now is every H-1B visa holders is stuck at one point of time with one employer, one job, doing particular one job duties only, and no promotions or no appraisals are happening at every level for them. And they have to continue doing that job till they get their permanent residency. Once they get their permanent residency, residency, then they can move on. Okay. So right, now what is happening is once the promotion is not there, they are stick to one job, and the entry level or mid level Americans who really want to get into the IT industry, there is no position open for them right now. So this is in itself an indirect, what we can say, indirect impact of green card backlog. So the more we focus on green card backlog, if we remove the diversity from the green card backlog, like it should be first come, first serve basis, then everybody will get the chance as they come in, as they file their applications, and things will keep on moving, and there will be not a bottleneck for one particular countries. Like, correct. So yeah. That's very important. So yes. I just feel that the root cause should be focused as well.
Yes. Thank you, Netra.
Right. Can I add something to the green card backlog, Vinaya?
Yes.
See, the allocation of there's about a 7% allocation to per country limit on these green cards. I'm talking about the employment-based green cards, starting from the EB1 category going into EB5. Now, most of our folks are hanging in between EB2 and EB3 category. So we're talking about roughly 5,600 green cards a year allocated to the to people who are born in India. Mm-hmm. So just for the audience, just keep in mind, even if you're holding an Indian passport, if you are born outside India, you would go with that country, not based on your current nationality. We've had employees where they were born in the United Arab Emirates but holding an Indian passport. You are not subject to the Indian nationality. So look at where you were born. There might be 0.5% of them who were born outside India were still holding an Indian passport. So we're talking about roughly, with all these categories, about 9,800 to 10,000 visas per year. Now, at this rate, if there is no reform on the GC policy, it would take for, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 years before people can actually get to that stage.
Okay, and Dan, can you also please enlighten us about your IT Pro Alliance and what is the main objective of it?
Okay. We started this open networking platform. It's a not-for-profit. It's kicked off in New Jersey. Then we are now expanding into other cities and states as well. The main objective of the this group is to connect people in the IT staffing arena, starting from consultants to consulting companies, staffing companies, and the hiring managers at the end clients. Bring them in one platform. For example, we've had one or two meetings in Jersey and Texas. People were extremely happy where we connected consultants with immigration attorneys. Then they were hiring managers from Fortune 500 companies. There were also staffing suppliers who were present. So it's basically, to start with, it's an open networking platform where we attempt to connect these people together, including the back office IT recruiters sitting out there in India who work through the night again as the nature. So we want to have everyone under one platform and help them with, numerous problems that we have. One of them is the H4EAD, of course, and immigration is not the major focus, but then, we would definitely have a department under the alliance to also help people with the immigration. Right now, we have several attorneys, we have a lot of professionals, we have about 2,000 or 3,000 people in our groups. We are working on a robust online website where we will traditionally take the memberships, but for the consultants, the membership is going to be absolutely free.
Okay,
and this is a unique organization. It's 100% not for profit. So we're all volunteering here, trying to help each other. So anyone, your listeners out there, please go to facebook.com/ITProAlliance to get more information on our activities. Thank you.
Awesome. Dan, I see two more callers here. Hello. Hi. Hello. I see two calls here, but they're not talking. Hello. Hello. I don't know. So, Netra, as most H4 EADs are women, and as a women entrepreneur, what would be the impact if H4 EAD is revoked by the administration?
So basically, women, as you said, like 93% are the spouses, women spouses, whereas only 7% are on H4s, as I mean, who are having H4 EAD, men are having H4 EAD. So from the woman entrepreneur point of view, if the H4 EAD is taken away, of course their life will be shattered for, and they will be, I mean, back to pavilion, sitting idle home. Or they will undergo a major financial crisis for few, at least those who have taken the bank loan to start their business, and they will be also having, I mean, they will also face a lot of psychological problems because of
I think there's a caller. Hello? 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 Hello. Yes, please, Netra, go ahead.
Yes, so the impact is very high here. So I, as I always say that once the public comment reopens for H4 EAD rule, please make your heartfelt comments to it. Add your stories to that. Whatever impact is going to happen on you, please make sure you comment as you comment, because those comments will really be considered. This particular rule was approved because of the comments, and this new rule, that is the revoke to H4 EAD, will not get approved, or it might just get terminated looking at the public comments. So you need to really focus on the positivity instead of just thinking that as a foreigner we cannot do anything. Your ask should be very strong. The more you comment, not just here in US, but everyone from the world can comment towards this particular once the comment period opens up for the rulemaking.
Right. Thank you, Netra. And Dan, what is your view on the impacts of such revocation?
Well, I totally go in line with Netra. But then number one is...
Vinaya, can you hear me?
Yes, Netra. Dan, are you there? Dan, hello?
Hello? Can you still, So if somebody is working there for the past 3 or 4 years, number one is the jobs, which might, be outsourced, or these H4 EADs might take those jobs and decide to move out of the country. And the financial stress that is going to go on families, a lot of them have purchased homes, and now with a single income, if somebody's making an average $80,000, now we are getting a new hit of losing $5,000 a month, and now they have to rethink of what to do with these properties.
Exactly.
And the economic tax loss into the government, number one. And what if they fail to pay these mortgages and credit card bills, thinking that, hey, I have a job, I just bought a vehicle, an expensive vehicle. And then I don't know if you remember in 2003 or 4, when there was a hit with the job market recession, I think I'm not sure it's either 2002 or 3, a lot of people have left their vehicles at the airports and left to India, not paying the, so anything, any hit like this will definitely have serious effects on the process and the economy. And finally, taking, H4 EAD is taking jobs, not really. And the companies that they floated, even if 5,000 H-480Ds have floated companies, if mm-hmm. they have hired two or three U.S. citizens, we're talking about tens and tens of thousands of U.S. workers losing their jobs as well. So indirectly, it's jobs that were already created for U.S. citizens or U.S. workers. Mm-hmm. And everyone out there listening on this show must understand that we have to come together and support the cause. Just like Netra was mentioning before, this is not just for, you know, today. People have to go comment, and please.
Dan, sorry to interrupt. We have a caller with us. Hello, hi, who's this?
Hi, I am Bhargavi. I'm calling from California.
Hi, Bhargavi. Please go ahead and ask your questions.
Yeah, I have been hearing the show, and I just want to know, you're asking me to comment for H4EAD, it will be taken, right? So where to go and where to comment? There is any website or link for this to post our comment kind of on the H4EAD rule?
Okay, I can answer that. Right now, they have not opened the, on their website, they have not opened anything to make a comment. As soon as, you know, we see new information, it's, you know, we have put up a small page called SaveH4EAD.com, SaveH4EAD.com. We will definitely post a link there to once it comes to the commenting period. Right now, the rule is under review by the OMB, Office of Management and Budget. So we still have a couple of more months before they open up on their website for public comments. So please go to SaveH4EAD.com to get an update.
And I have one more question. Actually, I have got my I-140 approval last week. We got our I-140 approval. And now I can apply for my H4EAD. So can I go ahead to apply for my H4EAD, or I should stop and check for the progress kind of? Is there a possibility I will get the H4EAD approval kind of?
Of course, right now, you know, nothing has changed. Nothing has changed. Everything is as it is. So if you have a 140 approved from your spouse, you should go ahead and apply and take the advantage. So far, nothing happened. Nothing negative happened. As we were discussing during the beginning of this show, it is very unlikely once they have an approval, you are paying a fee for it. And, you know, if something, you know, if you get an approval on the EAD, it might be active based on the approval dates, the duration on the work card, the work permit.
So I can go ahead and apply for my H4 EAD, right?
Yes. You should talk to an attorney. We're not here to give legal advice, but then please talk to your attorney and see how it goes. Okay.
Okay.
Thank you, Bhagavi. Thanks for your call. Yes, and Dan, do they have to stop working right after revocation, or they can continue until it get expires?
That is unknown at the moment. I've been talking about this, as I explained before. Most likely, you know, they won't say, hey, you know, we are revoking the policy today, and your employment must cease from the same day. Mm-hmm. And I haven't heard anything like this happening in the U.S. history, where if you've had a you know, a work permit, and they have canceled a rule that they, you know, the existing work permits going to drain. So once again, we do not know at the moment. Mm-hmm. Once we have more information, we'll try to post the information on SaveH4EAD.com.
Okay. And also, what about the renewal process? People who are already in renewal process, are they troubling to issue new H4 EADs, or what about that?
There is no trouble with the H4 EADs. It's a simple rule based on, for any EAD card, when they apply using the form I-539, the couple of things they need to keep in mind, especially for the H4 EAD, making sure there's a marriage certificate, clear marriage certificate, copies of the spouse's passport, and a copy of a driver license where they clearly show their, you know, picture for them to match. and pay stubs of the spouse and a copy of the H-1 and H-4 approval notices. So apart from this, usually they get, you know, once there is an RFE, now people post on social media stating, see, one thing we need to understand, Vinaya, most of these, you know, RFEs, the trouble, it's just an enforcement and, you know, we all blame the new administration, but I don't think so, in my personal opinion. It's just that, you know, things are getting enforced and we are getting chaotic. Hey, there's an RFE, now there are on groups, now immigration has started issuing RFEs even for H4 EAD. And I haven't heard of anything of that.
Okay. Okay. Good. And Netra, do you want to say something? I think we are good to close the show. Before we conclude, Netra, do you want to say something?
So I would really like to tell all the audience who is listening right now, as well as to pass this message to everyone who is who are citizens as well as non-citizens, to please unitedly stand together and I mean, keeping all your opinions, ideologies, fear on one side, please support H4 EAD. And once the comment period opens up, please make your comments and help these spouses to allow continue work. They are not taking your jobs. They are not, I mean, they are in the market giving proper interviews, as well as they are trying their own to make their own family life stable and indirectly or directly helping US economy to grow. So I request everyone to comment when the comment period open up, whether you are citizen or non-citizen, please help.
Okay, excellent. And one final question, Dan, Dan and Netra. Actually, I'm wondering what will happen to SSN if the EAD is revoked? Will it automatically become invalid?
Someone asked me this question, you know, on another radio show last night. Now, there's SSN is created, you know, given to an individual for the lifetime. And if you look at the SSN card for any non-immigrant person here, excluding green cards and U.S. citizens, it says valid for work with USCIS DHS authorization only. So nothing will happen to the SSN. You know, the SSN will not get canceled because it's provided by the Social Security Administration, not by the immigration. Now, SSN will go dormant, not dormant, but then it can only be used to work when you have a new work permit tomorrow. If they move into another category like H-1B, again, they can use the same SSN. They don't have to reapply for a new number. You know what I'm saying?
Correct.
And once again, you know, before you close the show, Vinay, I would like to request everyone out there, at least, you know, let's do our thing. You know, let's step number one. Is, you know, we have right now 61,500 signatures close to. Now, please go to save h4ead.com to find the link to the White House website. This is step number one. Once we have 100,000 signatures, we will definitely continue to support this. Maybe we will reach out to senators and create that impact. So the we have to make the administration think twice before totally knocking out this H4 EAD program.
Okay. Yeah. So thank you so much, Dan and Netra, for joining us for today. And it was a pleasure having you both on my show. You gave us a very valid information and people now will become aware of the scenario. And dear immigrant friends, hope this show will be helpful to you and hope you all gain a lot of information by Mr. Dan and Mrs. Netra. And thank you, Dan and Netra, for joining us today.
Thank you, Vinaya. Thank you for giving an opportunity to speak out.
It's our pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. అదండి మన బగింగ్ ఇష్యూ గురించి మాట్లాడడం డిస్కషన్ జరిగింది H4 EAD రివకేషన్ గురించి. సో హోప్ యు ఆల్ ఎంజాయ్డ్ దిస్ షో. అందరికీ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్, మీకు కావాలనుకున్న ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ దొరికింది అనుకుంటున్నాను. మళ్ళీ ఇంకొక షోలో కలుసుకుందాం. సూపర్ మచ్ అంటూ వచ్చేస్తాను. అంటిల్ దెన్ దిస్ ఇస్ మీ యువర్ ఆర్జే వినయా సైనింగ్ ఆఫ్ అండ్ స్పెషల్ థ్యాంక్స్ టు సుబ్బు ఫర్ గివింగ్ హర్ స్లాట్ టుడే. థ్యాంక్ యూ సుబ్బు. అండ్ తాత బాబాయ్ విను విను వించు ప్రవాసాంధ్రలో కొంటే చప్పుడు తెలుగు ఎన్ఆర్ఐ రేడియో.